All right, everyone, welcome back to 30 Days of Grammar. We're on day 7. For those of you who are wondering what happened on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, we were basically giving you some time to recollect your thoughts. And so you're going to find that in this series, the weekends will be a time that you, for those of you who missed anything throughout the week, you can go through, you can watch, you can catch up. It's a breather. And then on the Monday, we're going to pick up where we left off on the Thursday. So that is what we're doing today. So hopefully you understand the method behind the madness. Now, last week we looked at subject verb agreement. And this week we're going to be looking at types of verbs. Now, three different types of verbs will be covered in this video. We're going to briefly look at action verbs, then we're going to look at transitive and intransitive verbs. All right, let us begin. And once again, if you have any questions, any comments, please comment below. If you have any requests for any topics, please let me know. Now, when we talk about action verbs are verbs that express an action, and we know them quite well. So run, walk, do, drive. For example, I'll do my homework when I get home. So these are verbs, skip, jump, that express an action. Now, these are the verbs that we're most familiar with when we think of verbs. But then there are other types of verbs called, for example, transitive verbs. Now, transitive verbs always receive a direct object. And so Richard annoys his boss so much that he'll never get a promotion. Now, we see annoys, right? And his boss is the direct object of the verb annoys. And the promotion is a direct object of get, right? And so basically, in order to figure out whether or not a verb is transitive, you see if there's a direct object that receives the action of the verb. Now, coming again. Gemma brings Mrs. Smith lunch every day. We see here that the verb is brings, and the person who is receiving the action is Mrs. Smith, because she is the person that Gemma, the subject, brings lunch to. Now, so quickly, let's get it. When you think of transitive verbs, these are verbs that they have an object to receive the action, or always receive a direct object, all right? Now, some sample transitive verbs. And we say bring, send, owe, contain, buy, show, take, tell, verify, check, get, wash, finalize, annoy, lay, lend, offer, edit, make, phone. All of these are transitive verbs. And if you can make a sentence out of any of these transitive verbs, which is followed by a direct object, that will be great. And also, if you have any other addition, please comment below. Now, when we talk about intransitive verbs, if it transitive, the action is received by a direct object, what do you think intransitive verbs do? Now, intransitive verbs do not need a direct object in order to complete their meaning. Many are followed by an adjective, adverb, preposition, or verb complement. For example, if Katie continues to be late for work, the boss will fire her. Continues is followed by to be, and we're going to talk about that in our next lesson, the verb to be. And you notice that is not a direct object. And so once again, we see the bomb exploded in the city center. The fact that exploded, the verb, is followed by a preposition. It means that there is no direct object following that verb. So, coming again, if we want to talk about intransitive verbs, these are the verbs that are not followed by direct objects. All right, so let's look at some examples. Come, explode, laugh, sit, raise, excel, respond, run, cough, swim, immigrate, smile, act, cry, immigrate, lie, arrive, continue, die, go. And so you notice that some of these verbs also appear to be action verbs. So you're going to see a lot of overlap along the different types of verbs. Now, as always, we know there is an exception, that we have some verbs that can be both transitive and intransitive. And so this is dependent on their meaning. For example, Jamie set the document down on the CEO's desk. This is considered to be transitive because we have the verb set, and the direct object would be the document. Now, the sun set low over the Pacific Ocean. This is considered to be intransitive because the same verb set is here. However, low is an adverb. There is no direct object there. And so that is why it is considered to be intransitive. And remember, we said that in grammar, oftentimes there are exceptions to the rules. And set, so remember, a verb can be considered transitive or intransitive depending on the meaning of the sentence. Another one, Mrs. Tyson manages the accounts department. Can you tell me if this is transitive or intransitive? What is the verb? Is it transitive, intransitive? So the verb would be manages. And this is transitive because we see the direct object following the verb manages. Now, here is another example. John has had difficulty managing since his wife's death. What is the verb? Ask yourself, is it transitive or intransitive? Now, it is intransitive since is a preposition, and we're looking at John has had, as we know, is a verb, managing, and so we're looking at the fact that there are no direct object there, and that is why it is intransitive. So please remember that transitive and intransitive verbs can appear in any tense, verb tense, past tense, present, all right, sample transitive and intransitive: set, leave, give, study, sit, grow, smell, dance, sing, write, teach, burn, eat, paint, drive, manage, stop, climb, run, check, cost, go, pay, improve. Now, please be reminded that although we say these verbs can fall in the category of transitive and intransitive verbs, this does not mean that this or these categories are the only categories these verbs can fall in. So bear that in mind, and you're going to see that as we continue, there is a lot of overlapping. Now, the resource site that was used was gingersoftware.com. And so please check out the blog. You're going to see the link in the description bar. Complete the transitive and intransitive assignment. And then in the next video, we're going to quickly go through the answers and then move on to a different type of verb. Have a great day, everybody. Great night, great morning, whenever you watch this. And thank you very much for joining me. Bye-bye.